In this video, you will learn how to make an effective questionnaire or survey. Sometimes it is important for you to conduct a research about a particular topic where you want to make a conclusion. And then you send this questionnaire to a group of people from a large population and check your hypothesis or your research question. It is not possible for me to suggest you specific questions for your research area. But in this video, I will show you 10 important considerations which you should take into account when making a questionnaire for your PhD research question or any research question if you are part of a research group. And we are starting right after this short break. Hello and welcome to my channel. My name is Tahir, and if this is your first time, please hit the subscribe button and also the notification bell to get notified whenever I post a new video on this channel every Tuesday and Friday. This video was requested by one of my subscribers, Maria Zainab, and I thought that this is really a very important topic and I have no video on this topic, so therefore I decided to make this video. If you are interested in any other topic related to my area, please put in the comments and I will try to make that video as well. In this video, there will be around 10 tips for you. Two of the first one, I think that you should already know, which I will put in the beginning. And then I will present few more considerations for making an effective questionnaire. The first thing is that when we are making a questionnaire to conduct a survey, we are assuming that we will send these questions to a group of people. And that small group of people will be a representative of a large population. We cannot send this survey to thousands of people. We send this to 50 or 100 or 25 people. And then we assume that these people look like the audience which we are targeting and about which we want to get a conclusion, a result, and we want to get an answer to our research question. So this is the assumption I hope you already know. So this is the first thing. So this underlying assumption means that if your research is about PhD students, then you will be sending your questionnaire or survey to PhD students only. If it is about young parents, for example, then you will be sending to that particular group of people. And the second important thing, which I assume that you know, or your PhD supervisor should have told you, is that format of your questions depend on the method of analysis you will be using later on. So if you are using a statistical method, then you will be formatting your questions in a particular way. If you are using probability methods, then you will be formatting your questions accordingly. So these are the two important things which you should know already. Now let's talk about how to make an effective questionnaire. In any questionnaire, there are two types of questions. One are open-ended questions, where the participants have to write something. They have to write a single line, a fill in the blank, or a paragraph, and you don't give any options. They have to think about and write something as an answer to your question. So these are called open-ended questions. The other type of questions are closed-ended questions, where you give them some options and they have to choose one option from those set of options. Or you just ask them yes or no, or you give them a scale from 1 to 10 or 1 to 5 and they have to choose a number from that scale. So all these kind of questions are called closed-ended questions. So the tip is that if you are able to categorize your options, your answers, if you are able to do that, then avoid any open-ended question. Only ask closed-ended questions and give them some option and they have to select it very quick and you will get a better response to your questions. If it is possible, only put closed-ended question where you give them some options. If not, we will discuss this at the end of this video. Now the second tip is that you sit back and write down your research question with all its subsections and from all angles where you want to get answers. Then write down your focus group or your target group which you want to target to get answers to your research question. All the attributes of that group, for example, if they have particular demographics or if they have any particular level of education or level of income, whatever. So all their attributes. So all the dimensions of your research question and the focus group attributes. So now that you have decided your research questions and your focus group, now the next important point for you is to decide whether this survey should be taken at one time frame or at two time frames or more. Because some hypotheses cannot be tested with single survey. You have to conduct the survey at least twice. So this is up to you and up to your research question or hypothesis you want to test, whether you want to conduct a survey on one time frame or more than one time frame. So this is the decision you have to make now. Now after this, the next tip is when you start making your questions, try to minimize the number of questions. You don't want to have too many questions, because if there are too many questions, chances are that you will duplicate the questions. If there are too many questions, people will be reluctant to take the survey. If I see a survey with 50 questions, I will definitely not take that survey. So this is second important thing, to minimize the questions. The third reason we want to minimize the question is to avoid the confusion. Because sometimes if there are too many questions and you are not thinking about that, there might be some confusion. Now, once you have decided the minimum set of questions, now it's time to add some questions. And those questions should be about the attributes of your target group which you want to capture. For example, their age group, or if it is important for you to discriminate whether it's a female or a male participant, or their income, or their demographics. So you want to capture this information as well. So you have to add a few questions in order to do that. Now the next tip is about categories. When making categories, you should avoid including the other category. For example, if you want to ask a question whether you like this or this, and then you put another category, other. So this other category is useless, and it sometimes decreases the quality of your survey. Because what happens is that participants, they don't think too much, they just tick others. So they don't want to think. So other category looks good, but it doesn't add any value to your survey. So avoid this other category. Now the next consideration is, if you cannot avoid the open-ended questions, which we discussed in the first tip, then what you should do is always put the open-ended questions before the closed-ended questions. So the questions where they have to think and put their answer, always put them in front, because you want to invite them to think in the beginning. And again, remember, there should not be too many, one or two or maximum three questions. Otherwise, they will just skip the survey. So you don't want them to run away. So therefore, if it is extremely necessary for you to capture some valuable information, because when they are thinking, they are putting some very valuable information for you. So therefore, if you want to capture this, it's important for you and for some very serious research questions. For example, in medical sciences, these type of questions are very important. So therefore, put the open-ended questions first and then the questions with options. Now the last tip is that always pre-test your survey. Pre-test means give this survey to few people. If those are from your target group, that's fantastic. If not, you can even test this with ordinary people and see whether is there any confusion in the questions, whether they understand the questions, or whether they are getting some false impression from that question, or whether they are misinterpreting your question. So if there is a misinterpretation, you have to clear your question, change the wording. Because I have seen many surveys which contains very stupid questions, which make no sense at all. So therefore, rethink about your questions if during the pre-test you think that people are not understanding your questions. So this is very important, that always pre-test the survey before conducting the actual study for your research. So these were some of the tips. So I hope you like this video. If so, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching. See you next time.